Hi everyone, today I'm going to record the 59th chapter of my novel Farishta. So let's start. I went to the kitchen to ask the piece of paper and pen. I went to the same girl, the one she used to give me coffee for Salvatore, and I wrote down my email ID and one copy I gave to Raza and other to Salvatore. And I asked Raza, can you give me your email ID as well? He said, I don't know when we're gonna come out from this center. I said, we never know. Just in case you write it down, maybe there will be any way to, I will find some way to contact with you, or if you will have the time, you can contact with me. While I was talking with them, Maksud called me. He said, try to call that lady, find some way. I said, okay, I'll try to do something. I didn't have money. I took one Swiss franc from the same girl who used to give me coffee for Salvatore. There was one phone booth in the hall, and there was slot in it. I inserted coin. As I never used this phone because I had no one to call, and other reason was I never had money. Anyway, I inserted the coin in the slot. Maksud was telling me that lady's number, and I was dialing the number. I glued the receiver with my ear, and the bell was ringing, but there was no response. Finally, there was message in the telephone, in the mobile, so I recorded my message and disconnected the phone. Maksud said, she didn't answer, so I won't see her before I leave. I said, I have left the message on telephone. If she will hear the message, she will definitely come. We are leaving this place at 10 o'clock. If she would like to come, she will come. But Maksud's disturbance was annoying me. Security guard called our names. I went to Raza and Salvatore and hugged them strappingly. I was really sad leaving Raza. I was praying inwardly that I would love to see this gentleman again, because I was very much impressed with his knowledge, and I wanted to see him again. Security guard escorted us. There were other people with us, so the security guard brought us in front of the same building where I came first day. Then I came there many times. He placed his small badge in front of the machine, and the small door was open. All of us, we entered inside one by one. I came here many times, but I never noticed that in this building, in the entrance, in the reception, there are windows. In French, they call it guichet. There were three windows over there. So people were standing in the queues. Security guard asked me to stand in one queue. So I stood in one queue. And Maksud was standing next to me. He was standing behind me. And while I was standing in front of the window, there was only one person in front of me. And that lady, in every guichet, in every window, there were beautiful girls. There were young and beautiful girls were sitting. And I started waiting for my turn. And the person who was in front of me, that girl, she was giving him some papers, and she was explaining him what he should have to do. Finally, when that gentleman got all the papers, he left the window. Now I was standing in front of the window, and that lady, young girl, was sitting behind the window in guichet. She saw my housewives and gave me a train ticket. After that, she gave me a photocopy of some papers which had some map on it. She highlighted one line with yellow highlighter and said, I have given you train ticket up to Zurich, and from Zurich you will go to Winterthur. There you will, from Winterthur, and from Winterthur you will go to Zurich, and then you will have to go to that office, and that office is very close to the railway station. It must be 10 minutes away from the railway station. So you will have to report there. Did you understand? Or do you understand? I said, yes, I got you. After saying this, I left window for the next person, and next person was Maksud. She said same thing to Maksud, explained him everything, and then she said, did you get or did you understand? Maksud started looking at me. I told that girl that I will explain him. She said, he has to go to the same place where you have to go. So explain him briefly, explain him in a good way. And I want you to take him with you. I said, of course I will take him with me. Then she said, now you are free. I felt that I am free from the jail. I came out from that building very happily, but Maksud was very sad. Same thing happened with me when I phoned Susie. She didn't come, but I forgot everything now. We showed our housewives to the security guard and ticket as well. He opened the door for us. I came in front of this building by mistake on 15th of June 2002. I pressed the bell as well, but the door wasn't open because at that time this building wasn't ready. Today I was free. I was leaving this place and I was free. I felt that I am breathing after such a long time. Apart from initial days, we used to go outside twice, 2 hours in the morning and 2 hours in the evening. But we were bound to certain rules. We used to feel that they have given us freedom for a couple of hours. Like we got a freedom from our slavery for a couple of hours. But today we were completely free. We left that building and came in front of that barrack kind of building where I came very first day. When I was in that building, I used to see outside people walking outside freely. It was a sad moment for me. I became slave by choice. I remember my first night when I came here, spreading blanket on the floor and spending my night like this. I remember how I drank water from the bathroom step. I smelled the stinky stink of brook, which was just along the asylum center. The smell was killing me. The smell was very bad. For me, breathing was very difficult, but I didn't feel anything today. But today I didn't feel like this, like I used to feel before. We were walking along that dirty, stinky brook. We passed through the same subway which I used first day. I was walking to and fro first day. When I came, Maksud was with me. But he was very quiet, drowned in his thoughts. I was thinking, if train will be a little late, then I will go and collect my mobile phone from that net cafe. We came at the railway station after passing through subway. We didn't have any other thing other than train's ticket and our housewives. This train ticket was our whole asset. I was thinking, before leaving asylum center, I will take some 2 or 3 Swiss coins, and I will try to call Maksud's girlfriend just to know either she's coming or not, and I will tell her we are going to Zurich. But everything happened so quick that I didn't find any time to do all this. I wanted to say goodbye to Raza and Salvatore, but I didn't find chance. It's good luck. I took their email IDs. I was thinking that I will keep my contact with them, but I didn't know that it will be possible or not. Both of us came to the railway station and started waiting for the train. Our train was 15 minutes late. Our train was coming in 15 minutes time. It means I didn't have any time to go to the net cafe to collect my mobile. Because if I go to collect the mobile, there would have been chance that we would have missed the train. And the other train was after 1 hour, after 2 hours. Maksud asked me, do you have any money? I said, I have the same situation like you. How is it possible that I have money? He said, I have to call that girl to tell her that we are going to Zurich. I said, you know that? I phoned her. You were with me. She didn't answer, but I recorded the message. If she would like to come, she will come. Maksud said, you know that fat boy? He was saying that if you will marry with that girl, you will have bae. Bae means bae housewives. I said, he's so stupid. Wife can't be bae. Bae means mother. In Punjabi language, bae means mother. He said, I didn't mean that. I didn't mean by bae of Punjabi language. German bae means housewives, which has written bae on it. Be on it or be on it. I said, Maksud, it's such a sad thing. You have nothing to do with that lady. You think only about, you only concern about housewives bae. Maksud said, Farishta, what would I do with that lady? I don't know, she slept with so how many people? How many men? Once I have paper, she can go wherever she likes. Even if she go to hell, I don't mind. After hearing this, I didn't say anything. There was match today as well between South Korea and Germany. I was for sure that Germany gonna win the match. Not even me, everyone was convinced that Germany will win the semi-final. There weren't a lot of people at the railway station. Our train arrived at the platform. Both of us entered in the train swiftly. We had train ticket. Housewise, we had map of that place where we had to go. Train remained at the railway station at the platform for few minutes. Then train left the station. I had last glance of Kreuzlingen. The city was decorated with beautiful swans. The swans were displayed at different parts of Kreuzlingen. Then I thought about yachts and ships which were in the Bodensee. I remember their beautiful colored mast. They were moving here and there. German border was in the lake as well. Garnegie Hotel, where we used to go to spend night. The barrack kind of building, where I came first day. That hall where we used to eat. Agathu, where I took tea, where I had tea, where I took National Geographic magazines. I left magazines at Garnegie Hotel without reading them. That blue Toyota van, which was for our transportation. That fat driver who forced me to sit at the place which was reserved for the dog. That beautiful nurse who looked like French lady, that lady who had rough voice and Moroccan boy betrayed her, Italian security guard, fat man who used to serve us food, who looked like Pakistani singer Adnan Sami Khan, our meeting at terrace, sitting with Raza and Salvatore, and discussion about Dante and Boccaccio. Thank you very much. Like my video, subscribe my channel, and press the bell icon. I hope you like my video, and see you next time. Thank you.